안녕 친구들, 은비 언니예요. Today I am going to tell you guys a Korean fairy tale that every Korean knows. I'm not really sure if I can do this because I never tried telling this type of story in English. So the title of this fairy tale is called 선녀와 나무꾼. 선녀 is Korean version of an angel. So 선녀 is that imaginary beautiful woman from the heaven, but she doesn't have a wing, but she is wearing like beautiful like Korean dress. She normally has this ribbon behind her that kind of looks like a wing. So 선녀 is a female angel who is really beautiful and also from the sky. So of course she is capable of flying. And 나무꾼. You guys know what 나무 means, right? 나무 means tree. And 꾼 is a word for a guy with the skill. So combining these two words would be woodcutter. So to translate whole title, it's an angel and a woodcutter. So let me start the story. Once upon a time. Oh, by the way, once upon a time in Korean is 옛날, 옛날에. Old, old times. So let's start it again. 옛날, 옛날에 there was a woodcutter who is young and single. His living was poor, but he had a good heart and he was living with his mom. And he took good care of his mother. So one day he was doing his job in the mountain, and suddenly this poor deer ran into him and said, "Help, help me, please. The hunter is coming after me. Please save me. Please help me, and I'll pay back." So this nice guy couldn't let this poor deer to die. So he helped the deer to hide behind the woods he already cut, and the deer was able to save his own life and said, "Thank you so much, woodcutter, and I must pay back for this. And listen carefully what I'm telling you, and you must follow what I'm telling you to do." So the woodcutter listened carefully what the deer is saying. So deer said, "So go to this hidden pond on the midnight under the full moon. That's the day when those angels come from the sky for the bathing. And you must hide yourself very well. And while those angels are in the pond to wash their body, you steal one dress of theirs. Because that dress is what make them to fly so they can go back to the heaven when they are done with the washing. But since you stole one dress, one of them will not be able to go back to heaven and she will be freaked out. And you will be a hero to save her, take her to your home, provide all the comforts, and get married to her, and you will have at least four children. And until you have at least four children, you should never show her that dress." Okay, this kind of sounds really creepy, right? I mean, listening to this story in these days, it is a criminal, right? It definitely is criminal, but let's just forget about it, considering it's really ancient story. Okay, so the woodcutter did exactly what deer told him to do. So he was able to get married to the 선녀, who is really beautiful woman from the heaven, and they happened to have three children. They made a good couple and they were making a good family, good warm nice family. But imagine you are that angel. It's like you were kidnapped. All of a sudden, you just lost the way to go back home, and you don't have cell phones or anything to communicate with the heaven, right? So all these days, Sonia always missed the heaven, the home place. So Sonia always was sad looking at the sky, missing her home. But there was no way to go back home for her without that dress. And that made Woodcutter break his heart. I mean, imagine how miserable that would be. And this another day, in the night under the full moon, Sonia was out the door, looking at the sky, looking at the full moon, with a sad face, missing her home and missing her sisters. And that made Woodcutter break his heart so badly. And that made him to decide to show her the dress. He thought, well, the deer said it has to be for children, but we already have three. It wouldn't be so much different. So finally, Woodcutter called Sonia inside and started telling the truth that he's been hiding her dress all these years. And he showed the dress to Sonia. And Sonia was all surprised and tried that dress on. And immediately, she held her two big children in two arms and put the youngest child on her back and flew to the sky. Ta-da! She just disappeared. She just went back to heaven immediately, just as soon as he showed her the dress. And now the woodcutter became so miserable because he just lost his wife and children all of a sudden. So he fell into this big depression. He was so lost. And he happened to meet that deer again and told what happened. And the deer said, oh no, that's why I was telling you to have four children so she cannot fly back to the heaven. Because she'll never go back to heaven unless she's with all her children. If you have four children, there's no way she can carry all four children, so she'll stay here. But that doesn't help anything. It already happened. So Woodcutter asked the deer if there's any way to find them back. So deer started telling him, well, sir, actually, there is one way you can get back with them. But that way, you will have to leave this place and go to heaven and you will never coming back. That meaning you will leave your mother here and that's the only way you can get back together with them. Woodcutter was so obsessed, asked the deer what to do. So deer said, this day, this time, on the same pond you found her, that's the day the heavens sent down the bucket to grab the water from the pond. So once the bucket from the heaven comes all the way down to the ground, you get into the bucket and go up to the heaven. So the woodcutter did exactly what deer mentioned to do. So he was able to go to heaven and he finally met his wife and children and started living in heaven. So now the situation has been changed. Now, the woodcutter is missing his mother, the one who is old and left alone. So now that homesick depression came to the woodcutter, and he looked so miserable, and that broke Sonia's heart. So one day, Sonia came to woodcutter and said, honey, I feel you. I know how that hurts. So I will give you the chance to go down to the earth to see your mother. So here's the horse you can ride down to the earth. But you have to remember, you never take off from this horse. Otherwise, you can never come back to heaven. So the woodcutter was like, okay, I remember that. I'll just go down and I'll just going to say hi to my mother and just ask how she's doing, and that's it. I'll come right back. So he took on the horse and went back to his home. So the woodcutter and his mother had this dramatic reunion. And let's imagine what you'd do if you were his mother. Are you going to slap your son? If I was his mother, I might have slapped him. But this good traditional conservative Korean mother would not slap his son, right? So they were saying hi to each other, having conversation, how they were doing, how they missed each other. And the woodcutter didn't have that much of time. He had to go back to heaven. His mother's heart was breaking down. She was so sad that she has to just let him go. So she asked him for a favor. She said, "Son, I made your favorite soup for you. So please at least have this before you go. I want to see you eat this." She brought this hot soup from the kitchen and passed this to her son. He was all crying because he was so sad that he had to leave her. And he got this hot bowl of soup from his mother, riding on the horse, and started eating that hot soup. And what happened? He spilled that hot soup on the back of the horse. Because it was so hot, the horse was freaked out. So the horse started being crazy, and he fell down to the ground. And once he was off from the horse, and the horse started flying back to the heaven. Oh my god, isn't this miserable? And the woodcutter was like, "No! Come back! You cannot do this to me! I have to go back! I want to see my wife and children! I need to go back to my wife!" But that's never gonna happen. So he fell into the depression again. And since that day, all he does for the whole life is looking up the sky and cry. And his appearance gradually changed. He became a cock. So that's where the cock is from. And this story is why. And this story is why the cock, the male chicken, cries out loud, while female chicken doesn't make that huge sound. So this fairy tale is commonly known, like I mentioned. Every Korean knows this story, and it's always beloved by girls because it's such a love story, right? So I thought knowing common Korean fairy tale could be fun for you guys who are learning Korean language and culture, so I made this video. And I hope to make another video telling you guys another fairy tale. Thanks for watching. If you guys liked my video, don't forget to like and comment. And subs for love. And I'll see you guys next time. 안녕!